Alright guys, I'm going to remove this bit of inline JavaScript because I don't typically like working with that. We're going to be learning about comments in this video, and alerts, and console logging. This is my last video, don't mind that. Refresh here. Alright, so basically what we're going to do in this video is we're just going to learn how to use the language. So as you can see up here, when I created the JavaScript file, my IDE automatically added a comment. This is called a multi-line comment, and you create it by putting a forward slash and then an asterisk, and then you can drop down and it's, well, it automatically closed it for me, but if it doesn't for you, put an asterisk and then a forward slash. And everything between these two are not going to be interpreted or used at all. So I could say document.write, you know, anything I wanted. Da, da, da. I could even, you know, make something that's invalid in JavaScript. It's not going to be interpreted. It's not going to be parsed. And it's not going to be added to our page. We get no error here. So that is a multi-line comment, but more commonly we're going to be using single-line comments. Even if you have multiple lines that you want to comment out, you're going to be using two forward slashes, like that. So it's good practice to comment our code. In other words, when we do something for the next developer who might look at it, or if we are coming back to the project at a later date, we want to be able to quickly read through it and not have to read the code itself to understand what it's doing, although it should be written in such a way that is readable. And so we're going to be discussing that as we move through JavaScript as well. But for right now, we're going to learn about two functions. So a function is a block of code that does something. We're not learning how to create them yet. We're just learning how to use two built-in functions. The first one is called alert. And a function is written like this. Every line, by the way, every line in JavaScript is ended with a semicolon. I mean, it's not right now, because, and it will give me an error, unterminated statement, but JavaScript 2016? ECMAScript, they released a new version which basically you don't need to add a semicolon to the end of every line. But your IDE or code editor might warn you about that. So for right now, I'm just going to end it with a semicolon. So a function is written as whatever the function's name is. In this case, it's alert. And then an argument list. So we basically pass values into the function through these brackets at the end of the function. So I'm going to say, this is an alert. I'm going to save it. I'm going to jump back over here and I'm going to refresh, and you'll see an alert happens, a pop-up that says, this is an alert. And then I can hit OK, or I can hit up here, it doesn't really matter. This does block rendering and anything else that, you know, that's happening on the page. So the next thing, like alert, it's the console itself. So as you saw when we wrote document write, the document was an object that we were performing a function on. In the same sense, we're going to write console dot. And so the console right here is this right here. If we want to manipulate this in any way, and right now we're going to log something out into it, we need to access the object console. And once you access an object by its name like this, you can then put a dot and then access its method. So the console object has a method or function called log. And the log function can take any number of parameters, but for right now, we're passing in one string parameter, and we're going to say, this is a log. And I'm going to end that with a semicolon. I'm going to save this and refresh the page. Now you're going to notice when I refresh, until I hit OK, nothing is going to happen to the content. So I'm going to hit OK, and then we're going to see our console log out what we told it to log out. And it says, this is a log. Now you can also use the console itself to write things. So console log hi. As you can see in the console, it wrote hi. So that's the alert and console methods, and we're going to be using those quite a bit, so that's why I'm showing them to you guys first, even before we discuss functions themselves, because we're going to be making functions on our own. We're going to be learning in the next video about all the basics of JavaScript. We learned a bit about the syntax already. We learned how to write a function, and that we need to put a semicolon on the end of every line. So those are very important, but in the next video, we're going to be learning about basic types.